ठीक है, हमें ऑडिबल।
यस सर।
सर
ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वोल्टेज सोर्सेस, लाइक इंडिपेंडेंट वोल्टेज सोर्सेस, डिपेंडेंट वोल्टेज सोर्सेस। There are current sources as well, like dependent current sources, independent current sources. Like the voltage sources, where the voltage remain constant, in current sources, generally the current remain constant. Ideally, it remain constant, but for practical sources, they deviates from the no current, no load value, you can say, and we. Saw that the graphs are like this, and we also revised our basic knowledge regarding the Kirchhoff's laws, Kirchhoff's voltage laws and current laws. So we'll start with the. Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Hello.
Yes, sir. If the current is to be increased in a circuit, we require to increase the voltage as well, right?
What? I'm not getting.
Sir, if we want to increase the current in the circuit, in any circuit, we need to increase the voltage as well, right?
No, if the current is driven by a voltage source, then that is true. If that current is driven by some current source. Okay, so the voltage and current relationship, that whatever you have in your mind, that basically relates to the Ohm's law, but everything is not guided by the Ohm's law.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Sir, I have a question. Sir, sawtooth like wave, that if the sawtooth is over the x-axis, positive x-axis, then can we call it AC?
What? Sawtooth wave?
No, if the whole part is over the x-axis, then can I call it AC?
No, again, it can be called a mixture of AC and DC. Let me draw what you're saying. I think you are saying like this.
Yes, sir.
Are you saying like this? So it is a repeating sequence again. It is a periodic waveform, we can say. This particular signal is a periodic waveform. It has certain maximum amplitude, which is A. So it's a discontinuous type of periodic waveform, not continuous like sinusoidal waveforms. Anyway, but it has a particular DC value. Okay, so DC value it has. So if we can say it has some DC value, that means it's a mixture of DC, and also it is a mixture of AC. Though by AC generally we refer only the sinusoidal value, as I mentioned in the last class. Now you just you ask me that. Just a minute. Okay. Now you'll ask me that if I am claiming that by AC generally we means only the sinusoidal waveform. So here we don't have any sinusoidal waveform, isn't it? Now there is a theory which is called the Fourier theory. Okay. So by that, any periodic waveform we can represent that by infinite number of weighted sinusoids. So that means this particular non-sinusoidal waveform, rather sawtooth waveform, which we can see in this graph, we can represent this as a summation of several sinusoids. So in that way also we can call it a mixture of AC and DC. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any more doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So today we'll start mesh or loop analysis. Okay. Now, the mesh analysis and loop analysis, the basis of that is basically the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Whatever we have revised in the last class, that is the basis of this mesh and loop analysis. Now, I will assume that you all already revised the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Then I will go for this loop analysis. Isn't it? You are all... okay with the Kirchhoff's voltage law? Is it so?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If anybody is not familiar with the Kirchhoff's voltage law, you can raise your hand. Okay. I think everybody is okay. Now, I will first take a simple general circuit, not a specific circuit having some resistance values and voltage values. First, what I will take, a general circuit like this. My drawing can be a little distorted because it is difficult to draw this type of circuit in this type of boards. So you just draw your circuit in a better way. And the current directions are like this. The current here, this is the current, and here this is the current. You can also write down the currents like this, I1, this is I2. I4. I'm assuming the current arbitrary. Okay, and this is I3. And the voltage across this is V1. According to this current, this voltage will be V2, like this. According to this current, the voltage will be this, V5, here be minus and this is plus, so this is V3, okay, this is plus and this is minus. Okay, so it's a general circuit where this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the elements. Now these elements can be a voltage source, or can be a resistance, or can be anything else, any other elements which generally we come across for the electrical circuit. Okay. Now here just mute yourself. Somebody's
your voice.
Is my voice breaking?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. No, sir. No, sir. It's okay. But
okay. Sometimes it.
Sometimes it echoes.
No. Echo is for different reason. Somebody
no, sir. Because of me, I was trying to join through laptop, so.
So feedback was coming. If you are trying to log in from two different devices, from your end the echo will come. It's not from my end. From my end, what can happen that due to the network issue, the voice can be breaking. Okay, so that can happen. Anyway, I will ask you that in this particular circuit which I have drawn here. So how many loops you can find?
Two loops, sir.
Three, sir.
Three. Yes.
So
sir, three loops.
Three loops. Okay. What are the three loops? So this is one loop. This is another loop. And another loop, you are saying this one? Is it so?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now for loop A, if I write the equation, KVL equation, what should I write for loop A? You just try to write in your own. They want to write the equation for A, loop A. What will be the equation? Quickly, you try to write. Tell me. You all should try. Anybody? Completed? Global chain.
Yes, plus V1 minus V3. Plus V2 equals to 0.
V1 plus V2 minus V3 equals to?
V3. 0.
Okay, so I will ask somebody else for the loop equation B. Somebody else?
Sir, minus V3 minus V4 plus V5.
Once again, minus.
Minus V3 minus V4 plus V5 equals 0.
You are saying this? Are you saying this?
Yes, sir. I took the opposite direction.
Okay,
yes, sir.
That is not the issue. Anyway, you can take. And for loop C, somebody else.
Sir, do I say?
Yes.
Sir, minus V2, minus V1, minus V4, and plus V5.
V1 plus V2 plus V4
plus minus V5 equals to zero.
Correct. So these are the, so I will ask you all to rename yourself properly so that we can register it for the attendance. You just rename yourself properly. Okay, now we are getting three loops from this particular circuit, but here we have to understand that how many independent loops are there. Okay, now if we add the first two equations, we'll automatically get the equation number three, isn't it? Am I right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If we add first two equation, we'll get the equation number three automatically. So that means we can say that, okay, anyway, not only the equation number three, other equation can be also be taken as redundant. Now, here we have to understand that here we have two independent loops, or rather two independent loop equation, and another is dependent one. So we have to deal with only the independent loops or independent loop equations. So how we'll understand that how many independent loops will be there? For that, first we have to understand how many branches are there. So branches are the are those elements which contains the voltage and or the resistances. Like here, how many branches are there? Can you identify? How many branches are there? Now branches are those which contain some element in electrical circuit.
Sir, five branches.
Five, sir.
Yes. So we can write it a number of branches. Now, how many nodes are there? Now, nodes are those points on the electrical circuit where more than two branches are emerging.
More than two.
More than two, na?
Then two. Two. Two nodes.
Sir, greater than equal to two, na?
Two or more than two. So you are right. Somebody already has given this answer. That is, node equals to four, isn't it? So node gula ami already marked for each. So these are the nodes.
But in the first, in the left hand node, the only two branches are
That is the definition.
Main dutra branches hai ye hoche point side portion
right hand, this one also. So these are also called node. Okay, and one okay. More thing is there, how many separate parts are there? Now here only one separate part is there. Sometimes there can be two different parts of the circuit. So number of separate part is one here. So therefore, the number of independent loop equation, which is represented by M, M is given by B minus N plus S. Okay, so here, what is the value of B? B is here 5. N is 4. And S is 1. So therefore, the number of independent loop equation for this particular circuit will be 2. Understood?
Sir, what are the branches?
Branches generally contains the element. That means suppose there is a voltage source. Okay, suppose there is a voltage source. So this can be a branch. So from this to this, this can be a branch. Some branch can also contain some resistance. So this is another branch.
Sir, can you explain the separate parts? What do you mean?
Separate parts?
Separate parts,
sir?
Separate parts means here we have only one circuit. So sometimes we have two different circuits, but there is some dependency. Like if you take a transformer, there is a circuit for the primary and a circuit for the secondary. And if we write it side by side, then there can be two separate parts like that. So here only we have only one separate part. Got it? In most of the circuits, you will be given where you will come across only one separate part.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, parter paperta ekba bolben thik bujlam na.
Ami to otai bolchi. Je tomader jodi duto actually these all are basically comes from a graph theory. So that is not there in your syllabus. Okay. So separate part means if there are two different circuits which are not electrically connected in that way. Okay, so then we can consider.
Sir, can you give an example?
That example I was giving, na, if the circuit it comes from, if you represent a transformer, where you have a primary circuit, where you have the secondary circuit. So these two circuits are electrically isolated, but there is some relation, there is some dependency between these two circuits, between the voltages and currents, there are some relation, there are some dependence. So this type of circuits, when you will consider, then you have to consider two different parts, two different separate parts. Is that okay?
Sir, it means that they are connected but independent on their own.
Yes. Not independent, but they are not connected. They are dependent, but they are not connected. Electrically connected. But there is some dependence.
Means by some external method.
Some other, actually, if you consider the transformer, so here there is some current in the secondary, on which the primary current depends. There is some current,
sir,
in the primary on which some voltage of the secondary depends. Okay, so when you will give the transformer, that will be clear to you how we can get the two different circuits, but they can be dependent. So I am not going
into the details. Is there an example other than transformer?
Some electronic circuits are also there where this type of dependency you can get. Okay.
And it's similar to induction.
Not only induction. Not only induction. Okay. Actually, when we are considering two different circuits, in that way you can consider. Okay. So anyway, so let us take a circuit, then we'll discuss this theory in more detail. And what I will do, better I will actually, do you have the concept of impedance? Actually, I should not ask you because you have not gone through AC analysis and AC circuits yet. But anybody has any concept on the impedance?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How? That is the, from where you have got this concept?
Sir, in the AC chapter in class 12.
Sir, the RLC circuits.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So that was there the for all boards? Or only for the CBSE and like that?
In West Bengal board also.
in West Bengal board also. That's fine. That's fine. Then it will be easier to start this discussion because I won't take only the resistance because that will be a limited discussion. Better I will take impedance. Okay, so then it is a for a DC network when I will use only the resistance, that will be a special case of this particular circuit. I think you have understood this. মানে আমি যেটা বলতে চাইছি আমি এখানে একটা সার্কিট নিচ্ছি দ্যাট ইজ মোর জেনারেল ইন নেচার ইফ আই টেক অনলি রেজিস্ট্যান্স দ্যাট উইল বি আ স্পেশাল কেস অফ দিস পার্টিকুলার সার্কিট বিকজ ওয়ার অনলি দ্য রেজিস্ট্যান্স উইল বি কনসিডার You all should draw this circuit on your note. Sometimes it is easy to understand how many loops are there. You don't go for computing how many branches are there, how many nodes are there, simply by inspecting the circuit visually, you can understand how many these things are there. Okay. How many loops are there, isn't it? So in this circuit, which I have just drawn, how many loops can be there? You just by inspection, visual inspection, you just tell me. Anyone?
Three.
So it's very simple. So here we have three loops. So this is loop one, this is loop two, and this is loop three. And for loop current analysis or mesh current analysis, mesh and loops are used interchangeably. So for mesh or loop current analysis, generally we take a loop current or mesh current for each loop. Clear? So that is the thing which we have to do first. Suppose the network is given. Now what we have to do first for the mesh analysis, we have to assume some loop currents. Before that, we have to identify how many independent loops are there. So here we can understand very easily that there will be three independent loops. So therefore, we have to assume three independent loop currents like got it? Or any doubt? Any doubt?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I don't have any idea.
Idea of what?
Sir, impedance.
Okay. So if you don't have any idea, I'm just suppose you know the resistance. What is resistance? Resistance is something which opposes the steady value of current. Isn't it? That you understood, no?
Yes, sir.
Now what is inductance? Inductance is something which opposes the change in current. It doesn't oppose the steady value of current. If there is a steady value of current, that is, if the current doesn't change, inductance doesn't oppose it. And capacitance is another element in electrical circuit which opposes the change in voltage. These are the properties of this particular element. Okay, so all these are basically the opposing element. Now, when we do the analysis only in DC, we have only resistance. Can you tell me why? If our analysis is
because the current is still,
so there is no change in current or voltage. Because DC means constant current, constant voltage. As I mentioned, ideally DC means is a constant line with respect to time. With respect to time, there is no change in currents or voltage. So that is called the DC values or the DC quantities, isn't it? Now, when we discuss the alternating thing, that is the sinusoidal thing, then both the current and voltage changes. So therefore, we have to consider the effect of L as well as C. Okay, now how it opposes, how resistance opposes the current. What it does, it induces a voltage across it in opposite direction of the current. এই যে বললাম যে রেজিস্ট্যান্সটা কারেন্ট অপোজ করে, হাউ ইট ডাজ ইট, কিভাবে করে না, এটা কিভাবে করে না, রেজিস্ট্যান্স when some current is flowing through it, it opposes a voltage, it induces a voltage just in opposite direction of the current, and that voltage is given by IR. Okay, now inductance, I already mentioned that inductor opposes the change in current. So that means if there is some steady current I, it will not oppose. But if this I is a function of T and this IT is varying with time, so it will oppose that. So how it will oppose? It will induce a voltage across itself, and that voltage is given by L di dt. Similarly, if we have a capacitance and if the voltage across this capacitance, if the voltage across this capacitance DC is constant, there will be no current. But if the VC itself changes with time, then there will be an opposing current. So that means which direction the current will be opposed, current will be induced? In this direction. Okay, and that value is given, that current is given by this. Okay, so the voltage induced by the inductor is L di dt, and the current induced, okay, so let us take dVc dt because C is already included there. So that is the current which is induced by the capacitor. Okay. Got it. Now, when we consider AC, where we have some sinusoidal function, AC means the sinusoidal function. What is the omega there? Omega is the angular frequency. If the frequency is 50 hertz, then omega will be 314 radian per second. Okay, so that means the supply which we get as our household having 50 hertz frequency has the omega value of 314 radian per second. And what do you mean by 50 hertz frequency? 50 hertz frequency means this sinusoidal waveform will have a time period of 20 milliseconds. Okay, the sinusoidal supply which we are getting as our household will have 20 millisecond time period. That means 10 milliseconds it will be giving high voltage, but that is the positive voltage, and next 10 milliseconds, it will give you the negative voltage. So this type of waveform we get at our household. Correct? Now this type of thing is called alternating supply. alternating voltage, alternating current. Now, when we consider the alternating current, we have to consider the effect of L as well as C. We cannot ignore their effect. And as the effect of L and C depends on how the variables are getting changed, so therefore the frequency will come with them. Okay, so therefore the actual opposing force of L with for AC currents are omega L. An actual opposing force offered by C is 1 by omega C. And they are generally imaginary in nature. So J is called the root over minus 1. Here we don't use I because it may arise some confusion with our current convention I. So we use I, J instead of I. So J is basically the imaginary number I, root over minus 1. Okay, so these are the actual opposing force of L and C respectively for alternating currents. Got it? So therefore, if we make the summation for steady current, which was there in DC also, in AC also, that will be there for all current it opposes, that is the resistance R. Next opposing force will be given by the inductance. And the last opposing force will be given by the capacitance. And this total opposing force into current will be the voltage. So this is for AC. Now this total summation is called the jet, where jet equals to R plus J omega L plus 1 by, sorry, J will be in the denominator. Just a minute. J will be in the denominator, not in the numerator. Any doubt? Now have you understood?
Omega L by omega C ये कौन-कौन एक लैग पड़े बोले कि माइनस साइन
तो माइनस साइन एक्चुअली विल दैट इज एक्चुअली यू सी हियर यू आर गेटिंग जस्ट डेरिवेटिव रिलेशन इफ वी गो फॉर द वोल्टेज एंड करेंट तो वोल्टेज इज द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ करेंट हियर द रिलेशन इज इंटीग्रल रिलेशन इफ वी want to derive this V, actually this is C, 1 by C integration of integration of I so here the relation is derivative. Now here the integral relation is integral, so as it is derivative relation, so directly we'll get the omega out and we'll get J. Okay, so J means it's a 90 degree leading. Plus 90 degree lead. It will lead by 90 degree. And here, as this is integral, so here it will lag by 90 degree. So therefore minus J or 1 by J. I think this will be discussed in details in other part of the subject. Okay. So anyway, মানে তোমরা এইভাবে ভাবতে পারো যে for DC
স্যার এখানে J এর ফাংশনটা কি মানে J এর কাজটা কি হচ্ছে মানে J ইমাজিনারি যে
পার্ট আইওটাকে J দিয়ে রিপ্রেজেন্ট করে আইওটা
okay actually আমি এগুলোর মধ্যে ডিটেলসে ঢুকতে চাইছি না, তোমরা বারবার করে আমাকে ওর মধ্যে এসি অ্যানালিসিসে নিয়ে যাচ্ছ, দ্যাট ইজ নট মাই পার্ট অফ ডিসকাশন। এনিওয়ে অ্যাকচুয়ালি যেটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি আসে কিভাবে জানো, যেটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি আসে হচ্ছে সাইনুসয়েডাল ফাংশন ক্যান বি রিপ্রেজেন্টেড বাই এক্সপোনেনশিয়াল ফাংশন লাইক ই টু দি পাওয়ার জে থিটা মাইনাস ই টু দি পাওয়ার মাইনাস জে থিটা বাই টু জে। সো দিস ইন দিস টাইপ অফ সাপোজ ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ সাইন থিটা সো দ্যাট ক্যান বি রিপ্রেজেন্ট ই টু এক্সপোনেনশিয়াল ই টু দি পাওয়ার জে থিটা মাইনাস ই টু দি পাওয়ার মাইনাস জে থিটা by 2j. So this type of representation is there from what we get the phasor representation. সেখান থেকে এই যে টার্মটা আসে। ওকে তো তোমরা নিশ্চয়ই ওই যে যখন পার্ট
তো এটা কি মানে লিড করছে না ল্যাগ করছে, এটা লিড করছে না ল্যাগ করছে সেটা কি দেখানোর জন্য মানে যেটা দেয়া হচ্ছে
না না যেটা ডেরিভেটিভ করলে
যে মানে আমরা এর আগে যেটা পড়েছিলাম
যেটা থাকবেই, যেটা না থাকলে হবে না, যেটা ছাড়া তুমি এটা লিখতে পারো না কখনো। ওকে সো ইফ উই ওয়ান টু রাইট whatever you have studied, that is this one. Sorry, not this first root. This is the old
root. Yes, sir.
Eta plus of it, I mean, full column. So total imaginary plus.
Yes, sir. This is
whatever you have dealt with the magnitude of it, but it has a phase as well.
Yes, sir. We had only done the magnitude portion and the graph portion, the drawing the graph. And
the unit will be ohm. But why it comes with J, that will be discussed in AC analysis part. I follow? At a minus.
Sir, 1 by omega theta minus.
Minus of it, sir.
Minus of it. Because it is basically minus J. That I have written J. So 1 by J is basically minus J. Okay, but all the units are in ohm. So here also, when we are writing the unit of R, that is ohm, what is the unit of L? L is Henry. What is the unit of C? C is Farad. But when we are representing by J omega L, it has the unit of ohm. This has the unit of ohm. And Z also has the unit of ohm. So these are called reactants. This is called the inductive reactants and this is called the capacitive reactants. Both has the unit of ohm and impedance also has the unit of ohm. The impedance also has the unit of ohm. Okay. And the angle also you can calculate from there. Theta j, that is tan inverse omega l minus omega c divided by r. Okay, so anyway, I think that this will be discussed in the other part. So AC is not there in my part, but why I am considering here, because jeta tumra resistance diye shikcho, that is also applicable for impedance, that you should know. আর কিছুই না এখানে, just লেখার ব্যাপার। আমি z এর জায়গা আরও লিখতে পারতাম, আমি এখানে z লিখছি, এটাকে তোমরা r হিসেবেই ধরে নিতে পারো, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই। Okay, so get back to our original discussion. So what I will do, I will first write the KVL for loop 1. Now let me know what is the KVL for loop 1. তাড়াতাড়ি বলো।
স্যার E1 মাইনাস I1 ইনটু Z1
আচ্ছা স্যার স্যার বলো
মাইনাস Z3 ইনটু I1 প্লাস I2
E1 মাইনাস I1 Z1 তারপর কি বললে
E1 মাইনাস I1 ইনটু Z1
হলো লিখলাম তারপর
তারপরে স্যার Z3 ইনটু I1 মাইনাস I2
মানে প্লাস না মাইনাস অল ওভার I1 মাইনাস I2
মাইনাস স্যার
I1 মাইনাস I2 দিস ওয়ান
ইনটু Z3
এটা বলছো
ইনটু Z3
ওকে
Z3 স্যার
Z3 only I have
yes sir
is it okay বাকিটা সবাই চেক করছো এটাই পাচ্ছো
yes
yes sir
now the loop 2 quickly তাড়াতাড়ি লিখে ফেলো you all know the KVL equation it is only a matter of second তাড়াতাড়ি তাড়াতাড়ি
সার মাইনাস I2 ইনটু সার মাইনাস I2 ইনটু Z2
মাইনাস I2
মাইনাস ইনটু Z2 মাইনাস অফ I2 মাইনাস I3 ইনটু Z4
বুঝলাম না মাইনাস I3
মাইনাস অফ I2 মাইনাস I3 ইনটু Z4
এইটা
ইয়েস স্যার আই থিঙ্ক সো আর হচ্ছে মাইনাস অফ I2 ইনটু Z5
আর
ইনটু মাইনাস অফ I1 মাইনাস I2 ইনটু Z3
কি বললে
I2 মাইনাস I1 ইনটু Z3
তো মাইনাস তো
স্যার I2 মাইনাস I1 ইনটু Z3
তাহলে এটা প্লাস হয় বলছো
হ্যাঁ স্যার
ওকে ইউ জাস্ট অল ইউ জাস্ট চেক দ্যাট হোয়াট এভার হি হ্যাজ টোল্ড ইজ করেক্ট করেক্ট অর নট ইউ জাস্ট চেক ইট থরোলি And I will ask somebody else to tell me the equation 3 or no what a charging. Or no what a charging. Unmute or no what a charging. Unmute yourself. That means he is not there. Just logged in and out.
Hello, sir. In the equation 2, there is no Z5. Yes, sir.
No Z5.
Yes, sir.
Z5.
Sir, in third equation, I2 into it may be Z5, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Anything else I missed? Swastik Acharya, can you unmute yourself? You just tell me the equation 3.
I2 minus I3 into Z4.
Okay.
Minus I3 into Z6.
I3 into Z6.
Minus I3 into... Yes.
Bolo? Tarpor, bole jao, bole jao.
Then, yes, minus E2 equal to 0.
All you just check whether Swastik told correct or not. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now,
yes,
what yes, we'll sir. Do, we got three loop equations, but generally KVL equations we got. But what I'll do, what we'll do, that we'll try to generalize it. That means, suppose we'll write some equation where all the I terms will be there. So if you write like that way, what will be the first equation? Now here, this equation, we can modify that slightly like this. And the equation will be I1, Z1, and this one will be not only Z1, it will be Z3. Minus I2 Z3 equals to E1. Can't we write like this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, the second equation. So all this can be positive and this will be negative. Or if we take this positive, then we have to change this. Sorry. Okay, then all the terms will be positive only. So if we do like that.
Sir, I2 into...
You have already checked, huh? Now, what is the term associated with I1 here? That is only minus I1 Z1. Sorry, Z3, no? I1, Z3. Next term for
I2,
yes. I2 ki ki ache? Z2 or Z3? No, Z2, Z3, Z4. And Z5. So I2 into
yes, sir.
Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 plus Z5. All the Z's are there with I2. And what else there in the circuit? I3. I3 in this equation also. So that means minus I3 Z4 equals to 0. Okay, total number of terms mile chhe? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so number of terms are matched. So this we can write as equation 2. And the last one, if you simplify it, like those. What we can write?
I2 into Z4 minus of I3 into Z4 plus Z6 equal to E2.
Minus I2 into Z4 plus
I3 into Z4 plus Z6.
Equals to E2.
Minus E2, sir. Equals to.
Equals to minus E2, right? Okay. Minus E2. Correct.
Yes, sir.
So, these are the three equation, or you can say the modified equation in terms of I. Different I, I1, I2, etc. Okay. Now the first equation we can write like this. I1 has some term that is Z1 plus Z3. I2 has some term that is Z3. But I3 doesn't have any term. And I4 doesn't exist. Can it is.
So there is no I4.
I'm not writing. I could have left you now. Now here we have I1 Z3 plus I2 Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 plus Z5. Minus I3 Z4 equals to 0. Equation 5. And the third equation, there is no term associated with I1. So I1 into 0. Now I2 has some term. Let me check, correct the sign. After what I will check, correct that. It okay. Now we'll concentrate on these three equations only. Whether these three equations are okay. Anybody? Anybody say yes, otherwise I am not, I couldn't proceed.
Sir, I'm not sure, sir. I have to see the diagram once again.
Huh? But diagram
I'm not
is...
sure. I have to see the diagram.
Because diagram is already there in your notebook, na? You should take the running note. You should take the running note. Okay, so with respect to the diagram only, all this equation 1, 2, 3 were written. And based on this equation number 1, 2, 3 only, we are just writing 4, 5, 6. Okay, so if we have this equation number 4, 5, 6, then what we can write? We can write this equation in a one matrix equation, and that will be Z1 plus Z3 minus Z3, then 0. We'll take only the term associated with I1, I2, and I3. So in the second, we have minus Z3. Here we have the term Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 plus Z5. And here we have minus Z4. Here we have 0 minus Z4. And here we have Z4 plus Z6. So this into I1, I2, I3 equals to the voltages that is on the right side. E1, 0, minus E2. Okay, so this can be equation 7. Okay. Can you write this matrix equation from equation number 4, 5, and 6? You should speak out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But I understood one thing that all are not doing the class in seriously. Somebody is there, not there in front of device, and attendance is very poor. Only 40 or 39 participants are there. Though yesterday we have almost 55 to 60 participants. Now we have only 39 participants. I don't know why. So I'm taking the class in the scheduled slot. Still participants are not there. Still students are not attending. Though you are attending, but somebody is not there on in front of the device. And who is this fellow? Shantapal?
Yes, sir.
What's your name, actual name?
Shantapal.
Why you have written all this in your name? I already mentioned now you have to rename yourself properly. Whether this name is there in your roll sheet?
Sir, I changed the name to Shantapal, sir.
Why do you have changed?
Wait, sir. Let me. Sir, what is it showing? I am not sure.
You just go to the attendance, this participant list.
Sir, it is showing. Display name is Shantapal. I have written, sir.
No, it is not showing yet. Okay, so let me change that. Mute yourself. Next day when you will join the Zoom meeting, then you just rename yourself first, then you join.
Sir, is it showing, sir, UNEP Russia something?
Yes, yes. Now I have changed that. You will not see that.
Oh, sorry. I was in a MUNEP. Oh, sorry.
Shayan Ojha, unmute. Shayan Ojha. Shayan Ojha. UCR is there?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So Mark Shayan Ojha absent. And I asked somebody else before. You mark they mark him also absent. This Arno Bhattacharji. Arno Bhattacharji.
Yes, sir.
Just a few minutes back I called you. কোথায় ছিলে তুমি বাবা
স্যার স্যার আমার স্যার মা আসলে উপরে ডেকেছিল স্যার আমি গেছিলাম ওই জন্য
সরি দ্যাট শুড নট বি দ্য থিং না ইউ আর অ্যাটেন্ডিং দ্য ক্লাস দিস ইজ অফিশিয়াল ক্লাস ইউ আর অ্যাটেন্ডিং হাউ ইউ ক্যান লিভ ইওর ডিভাইস
স্যার অ্যাকচুয়ালি মাই মা Sir, actually, my mother is also taking a class of her school and she called me to help her out. That's why I went. Sorry, sir.
Okay, next day, I'm going to be absent. Okay. So anyway, so this is the matrix equation. And we should write like this, Z, capital Z, into I equals to E. Okay, so all these are in bold. So that means that represent these are matrix and vectors. So here J is the matrix, I is the vector, and E is the vector. Okay, now you can tell me that how I will solve the currents then. So let me solve I1. How I can solve the I1? By using Cramer's rule.
Some matrix E1, E0, E2, E2.
Directly Cramer's rule. So divided by delta. Delta means the delta of this, the determinant of this. And here we have to, but the first column will be substituted by the voltage vector.
Yes, sir.
This is E1. Am I right? Data coach.
Yes, sir.
So I already checked that you have already aware of the Cramer's rule. So this determinant will be in the numerator, and the denominator will be the mod of the determinant of Z.
Sir, in exam, can I use our calculator to solve the equation or
do? Or else you have to show the steps. You have to show the value of this determinant. In some calculators, you can solve three simultaneous equation directly. But you don't use that tool.
Yes, sir.
I know that. But you don't use that tool. You have to show the steps. You have to show the determinant, okay, value of the determinants. If you are solving by the Cramer's rule. Anyway, so this is the technique by which it is very easy. Now, why it is easy, I'm just telling you that. Let me take this one. Just a minute. Anyway, so you just look at the circuit first. then by inspecting the circuit itself, you cannot go through this KVL equation and you have to modify that. Directly by inspecting the circuit, you can write all those loop equations, isn't it? Like for the loop one, what will be the loop one equation? Don't go by this KVL. Only look at the circuit. Only concentrate on the circuit. Now, what will be the first loop equation? Now, in first loop, then what are the impedance is directly associated with the first loop? That we have to identify first.
Z1 and Z3.
So just write Z1 plus Z3. Okay, and what is the value of the first loop current? I1. Okay. Now, what is the intersection between the first loop and other loops? Where is that intersection?
Z3.
Okay, and Z3 will come with a negative sign. And the value of the current will be the loop current to which it has intercepted.
I2.
Okay. Is there any other interception with any other loop? With loop one? Loop one is the only other kono loop interception. Loop three interception.
No, sir.
No, that means it is zero. No means it is zero. Then equal to the voltage present in the loop one, but the sign you have to consider as per the current direction. So as per the current direction, we are raising the voltage, we are gaining the voltage, so it is plus one. Got it? Now go for the loop two. So you just see here, I have not go by the Kirchhoff voltage law. Only by inspecting the circuit, I am directly writing the loop equation. Now for loop two.
Minus Z3 I1.
Okay, so first I will write the first diagonal element. First I will write what are the self elements of the loop. Self element, there are four self elements. If I write serially, so Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 plus Z5. So these are the self element of the loop. So that will always come with positive sign and the loop current will be used. Now you search for the intersection. Now intersection with the first loop is what? Where? Z3?
Z3.
It will be minus
Z3
into I1.
I1.
And with the third loop also it has some interception.
Minus Z4, I3.
And last, the voltage it right side
to zero.
Because there is no voltage sources present in that loop. Okay. For the last one also, the third element will be its self element, and that will be Z4 plus Z6. Z6 into I3. Before that, we should write the intersection with the loop one. There is no interception with the loop one, but with the loop two, it has some intersection. That is Z4. Through via Z4, it has some intersection. And what is the self voltage of that loop? Voltage sources are present in that loop, but in opposite direction to the current. So therefore, it will be minus E2.
Minus E2.
So got it. So how we can write the mesh equations and loop equation directly from inspecting the circuits? Is it clear?
Sir. কোনো গ্রুপের সাথে কানেকশন যেখানে থাকতে সেখানে নেগেটিভ হচ্ছে তাহলে কি কোন ক্ষেত্রে ওটা পজিটিভ হতে পারে না
পারে তুমি যদি লুপ কারেন্ট গুলোকে বিভিন্ন কনভেনশনে ধরো এখানে এভরিওয়্যার আই হ্যাভ টেকেন দা লুপ ইকুয়েশন এন্ড লুপ 1 এর সাথে লুপ 2 এর কারেন্টটা দেখো অপোজিট ডিরেকশনে আছে সো দেয়ারফর ইট কামস উইথ দা নেগেটিভ সাইড এবার তুমি যদি তোমার কনভেনশন যখন খুশি চেঞ্জ করা যায় কিন্তু জেনারেলি কনভেনশন চেঞ্জ করলে এটা কনফিউজ হয়ে যাওয়ার চান্সটা বেশি তুমি যদি মনে করো যে আমি যে কোনো ডিরেকশনে কারেন্ট ধরতে পারি লুপ ওয়ানটা এদিকে ধরেছি তো কি হয়েছে আমি লুপ টুটা এদিকে ধরব তাহলে পুরো এই কনসেপ্টটা চেঞ্জ হয়ে যাবে সেক্ষেত্রে এইটা প্লাস হয়ে যাবে যে থ্রিটা প্লাস হয়ে যাবে কেননা দেখো অ্যাকর্ডিং টু বেসিক্যালি আমরা যাই বলি এটা তো বেসিক্যালি কেভিএল থেকে আসছে আরবিটারিলি তো এটা আসছে না আমরা স্কেবিল থেকে লিখে দেওয়ার পর আমরা রিভার্স ইনটিউশন করার চেষ্টা করছি তাই না বেসিক্যালি ইট কামস ফ্রম কেবিল বুঝতে পেরেছো ওই সেম সাইন সাইন গুলো ওই কারেন্ট ডিরেকশনের উপর ডিপেন্ড করবে এখানে আমরা সব ক্লক ওয়াইজ যদি ধরি তাহলে এই এই এইভাবে আসতে পারে সবকটা একই কারেন্ট কনভেনশনে ধরেছি সবকটা ক্লক ওয়াইজ সেই জন্য এটা হচ্ছে মাইনাস যত যদি একটা ক্লক ওয়াইজ একটা অ্যান্টি ক্লক ওয়াইজ ধরলে আর কিছু না তোমার প্রবলেম হবে ভুল কিছুই নয় এনি লুপ কারেন্ট ডিরেকশন ইউ ক্যান অ্যাজিউম আমি বলতে পারি না যে তোমাকে একটাই লুপ কারেন্ট ডিরেকশন তুমি ধরতে পারো বাট একই ডিরেকশনে ধরলে কনফিউশন ভুল হয়ে যাওয়ার চান্সটা কম সো দ্যাট আই দ্যাট অনলি আই ক্যান সি তো এই এই সার্কিটটা কি জেডটা নেওয়াতে কিছু অসুবিধা হয়েছে আমি জেড এর জায়গা আর লিখলেই দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাপ্লিকেবল ফর ডিসি অনলি নাম অনলি দ্য নেম ইনস্টেড অফ আর আই এম ইউজিং জেড সো ইজ দেয়ার এনি প্রবলেম
বুঝলাম স্যার নো স্যার
তার জন্য আমার এই এতটা ইন্ট্রোডাকশন দিতে হয়েছে সো 30% অফ দ্য ক্লাস was there to explain what is impedance though it is not in my part anyway I thought that today I will discuss my numerical problem but I think I won't get the time because up to 2 only I will take the class okay now you just tell me that you have understood this thing or you have any doubt okay jai ho mane revision hoye
gelo
ডিভিশনটা দরকার ছিল ইম্পিডেন্সটা অনেকেরই জানা আছে অনেকেরই জানা নেই যাতে জানা আছে তাদের ডিভিশনটা হয়ে গেল ওকে সো অ্যাকচুয়ালি হোয়াট আই কল ইট সো লাইক আওয়ার ডিফেন্স ইউ নো দ্যাট হাউ মেনি armed forces are there different armed forces are there in our defense
three
what are the three armed forces
air force army and navy
army navy air force okay so you can call it this is the defense for the electrical circuit and here r is basically army J is basically Navy and this is basically Air Force. Okay, and Navy and Air Force doesn't do anything on the ground, on the land, isn't it? Okay, so this way you can remember. So we have three armed forces. For circuit also we have three opposing forces, resistance, inductive reactance and capacitive reactance sobari kaj hocche current ta ke oppose kora but in different nature okay Now, if we think of DC, now you know for DC the frequency is zero, therefore the omega is zero. So that means DC is a special case of AC. For DC, you can put omega equals to zero. In that, your Z will be R only. Clear? In that way also you can think. Anyway, so I'll stop here for today. If you have any doubt, you can ask me still. Whatever time we have left, 5 minutes, is not sufficient to work out for numerical problem. So next day we'll start with the numerical problem only. So therefore, I will suggest you to sit with a scientific calculator. Today also, I pass this message to your seer. So next day, scientific calculator jogar kore niye bosho, because you have to run with the class. Tomar jodi mone hoy je class ta class er moto hok, amar just attendance pelei hobe ba attendance na peleo hobe. তাহলে কিন্তু ইন দ্য এক্সাম ইউ উইল বি ইন ট্রাবল অ্যাট লিস্ট ফর ইলেকট্রিক্যাল ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং এক্সাম আই ক্যান টেল ইউ আই ক্যান অ্যাসিওর ইউ ইউ উইল বি ইন ট্রাবল ওকে এনি ডাউট এনি কোয়েশ্চেন ওকে নাও ইউ জাস্ট টেল মি দ্যাট What about your electrical laboratory, basic electrical laboratory? Sir?
Sir, it hasn't started yet.
No, no. Anybody contacted you? Any
yes, sir.
Concerned teacher? Who is the concerned teacher?
Yes, sir. I contact me, sir, and he send a schedule of the electrical laboratory classes.
Okay, okay. That schedule.
We have our first class on 8th June.
8th June. Okay, and that will be taken by Mihir sir only?
Mihir sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And that experiment, the sheet, I think you have? Instruction sheet?
Yes, sir, we have the sheet. Yes, sir. Yes.
So, read the first instruction sheet, that is the experiment number 2. That is, I think, the measurement of resistance, like that. Okay.
Okay.
And any video on the actual laboratory you received?
No, sir, we don't receive any video.
And sir, will you please provide today's class recording?
Yes. Why not? The class is being recorded.
Sir, may I provide you with my mail ID?
No, that is there in my YouTube channel.
Oh, sir, that's good, sir. Will you please provide the link?
For last class also, you didn't get that? For last class also, I shared the YouTube link?
No, sir.
Why? Sir, you didn't...
Yes, sir. Now I saw. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now I saw. Okay.
You should check...
Yes, sir.
Approximately 40.
Okay. So 40, 90,
yes, sir.